is this Michael Gunton?
Hi, Velda.
Hi, you're live on the Velda Beebe Show, live from Dallas, Texas on KKVI. Thanks for joining us.
That's nice to be with you.
Well, you've got your newest film, One Life, and it's narrated by Daniel Craig. Tell me about that.
Well, it's been a kind of labor of love for about a year and a half with myself and my co-director, Martha. It's the story of a common story that all animals face throughout their lives. It follows the life of any animal from the moment it's born throughout its life to the moment it has babies of its own, and looks at all the challenges that you face through your life, through their lives, and looks at the challenges and how they overcome them, all the amazing ways that they come up with to overcome those challenges. And what's particularly important about it is that you get a sense of connecting with those animals, because when you see those animals, you see perhaps your own lives reflected in theirs, not directly, but sort of implicitly. So when you see an animal struggling to bring up its own babies or to try and find its food, you sort of go, I know exactly what you're going through. I've been that. I can connect with that. So I think I hope people will get that sense of reflection of their own places in nature.
Today, my guest is Michael Gunton. He's known as a master of nature film. He's also an Emmy-nominated natural history filmmaker. Now, he's best known for his nominated nature documentary series, Life. You just talked a little bit about One Life. Do you have something you can tell us about Africa? Because I know they're two extraordinary films.
Yeah, the Africa series was the thing I did after Life. That's, that sounds strange, doesn't it, after Life? But anyway, after the Life series. And that's... That was took 4 years to make that as well. That's the idea there is to tell the story of the whole of the African continent. You know, lots of people have made films in Africa for years, individual stories in Africa, but nobody's really looked at the whole continent and tried to tell the story of what that whole continent is like. And after all, it is it's the top wildlife place in the world. You know, it is the ultimate wildlife location in the world. And so we thought that if we could look at all the different areas of Africa and tell the story of those places through the eyes of the animals that live there, there'd be a really compelling story to tell. So we spend time in the Serengeti, in the Sahara, down in the Kalahari, in the Congo forest, on the Cape, where the sea has its massive effect on the land, and it's a really sort of an epic journey, if you like, around this extraordinary continent to see all the highlights of that continent.
Well, you've been able to capture Daniel Craig to narrate One Life, and when you did Life, you got Oprah Winfrey. What did you find in their voices that connected with what you were trying to show us on the screen? What was unique about them?
Well, getting Daniel Craig was a bit of a coup, I must say. I was very pleased about that. I wanted to work with, have his voice on documentaries I've worked on in the past for years, because I've always liked his voice, and it just so happened that this all came together and we were able to connect on this movie. What I liked about Daniel's voice is he's got a really rich voice, but it's not a theatric voice. It's a kind of voice of the common man, but it's got this wonderful depth and texture to it. And when we were recording it, the girls were all saying it sounded like somebody pouring hot chocolate out of a cup and landing on the ground. And it's this warm, lovely. And, you know, he has got a very, very good range of nuance in his voice, so he doesn't overplay it, but you really get the depth of the emotion that the animals are going through. And you know, when he talks about that mother octopus taking its last breath and blow water over its babies so that they can come out of the eggs and swim off on their own lives, you know, most people have a little tear in their eye, and we're talking about an octopus. So you know, that's the power of a good voice.
What about Oprah Winfrey? What did you like about her?
She, again, a very warm and very kind of, when I say matter of fact, isn't the right word. It's a voice that feels like it's true. It doesn't feel like it's overperformed. And I think it's very important. So much is kind of overdone. To have somebody who can make you feel like it's a storyteller, somebody who's genuinely telling you the truth and the reality but also wrapping it up in this kind of engaging and personal story. I mean, one of the things that I think when a narrator really does it perfectly is when you forget that there's anybody else in the world listening to this story. It's just you and that narrator's voice, them coming directly to you.
Oh, Oh, that's right. That ranks up there with a Sunday sermon. That's pretty good.
Yeah.
Michael, when I think this comes out, One Life comes out on DVD and it also premieres. Tell me how you want people to have access to it.
Well, One Life is opening in theaters around the country on Thursday, and they can find out about it on onelifeonscreen.com. That's the website, onelifeonscreen, all one word, .com. And then there's the Africa DVD, and it's a Blu-ray as well. And I do the Blu-ray, by the way, is the thing to get if you can, because the quality on the Blu-ray, even better than if you ever saw it on a TV screen at home. When you see it through the Blu-ray, the quality is extraordinary. And that's available on Tuesday, February the 26th.
Michael Gutten, I thank you so very much for talking about your wonderful films. I can't wait to see them. I will definitely partake in this wonderful adventure that you're going to give us for, you know, this great census for our eyes. I thank you so much, and good luck on all you do.
It's a pleasure. Nice to talk to you.